right, so if you read the title correctly to this video, you probably know why I'm playing Modern Warfare 2. One, because it's my favorite Call of Duty, and I feel like playing it. Two, probably the most legendary map ever. We all know that Nuketown is arguably the greatest Call of Duty map, but you cannot count out Rust, okay? Rust is the fucking map, okay? Rust was Rust before there was even a Nuketown. Rust is where the majority of quickscopers and snipers and stuff like that learned how to quickscope. Rust is where you 1v1, bro. If you want to catch a fade with snipers, which makes no fucking sense, but hey, in the Call of Duty world, it makes perfect sense. Then you catch me at Rust. Free for all, 30 kills to win, health on minuscule, radar always on, no kill streaks, no flashbangs, no stuns, no frags. That is basically Rust. The brand new DLC for Infinite Warfare has been released, and there's some good things about it that people are liking, and there's some other bad things that people are not liking. And the main thing is, you already know, the Rust is coming back to Infinite Warfare. If you guys haven't seen it yet, I'll post a picture of here on screen. All right, so the map is called Excess. It looks pretty freaking cool. Some of the maps here look cool. This is Rust. As you can see, it's completely reimagined. I'll put them here side by side in case you don't remember what Rust looks like. It just looks like Rust in like the year 2000 and something.
Well, no shit.
The map actually looks cool. It's a pretty cool design. But there's one thing that people are having an issue with. Why is Rust on a game with jetpacks? Rust is arguably one of the smallest maps to ever exist in Call of Duty. Now, for those of you guys that are liking the map Rust, you may ask yourself, why are people complaining about Rust being remade? It's a great map. It's a legendary map. Everybody loves Rust, right? Well, the main reason that people are complaining is basically because Infinite Warfare is the one that's remade. Making Rust. They're a little bit scared that the whole advanced movement is probably going to screw up the map. That's one of the reasons I've seen over on Twitter, for those of you guys who are not on Twitter usually. The other reason is, which to be honest, it doesn't really bother me. It only feels like they're making 3 maps for each DLC map pack, because the first DLC map pack already had one multiplayer map remade, and now they have Rust as another remake. So essentially, they're giving us 3 maps instead of 4, because the remakes don't count. I think maybe if we were to go back into how map packs used to be when they were bringing back maps, where all they did was literally copy and paste the maps, then you could probably say that. But now, the remakes are literally like different maps. They're essentially the same concept, but the maps look completely different. It's got a whole different look, a whole different vibe. Well, damn, that was pretty damn good. By the way, if you guys are wondering, IW DLC comes out on the 18th of April. I believe it's next Tuesday at the point of me recording this video. That guy got his ass whooped. So I'm going to give you guys my opinion as to how I almost got destroyed by that fucking noob tube. What do I think about Rust and it coming to Infinite Warfare? To be honest, when I played Modern Warfare 2, I don't know what time you guys played MW2. If you played it during its life cycle when it was hot like a pancake, maybe a few years later after it was released. But when I played Modern Warfare 2, which it was actually when it was in its prime, the way that I played it and the way that I only like to play Rust was when I wanted a 1v1 a mofo. Whenever Rust got picked like on a domination or TDM, it was a clusterfuck. That map is amazing. It's a legendary map, but I loved it for a map to 1v1. And that's why I have good memories of Rust. I don't have good memories of Rust because I was getting hammered by a Harrier and a Pavlo every 4 seconds, because that's essentially what Rust is. It is literally a clusterfuck. It's a fun map if you want to mess around and whatnot. But of course, that doesn't devalue the map as a great map, because it is probably one of my top 3 favorite maps of all time, just because of the memories that I had in that map. And speaking of Pavlo, there is a fucking Pavlo and it killed me. So here's the bottom line for me. I don't really mind Rust coming back into Infinite Warfare, because I'm actually going to try the map out and I think I'll probably enjoy it. Obviously, I'm mostly going to play the map more on 1v1s whenever I do 1v1 in Infinite Warfare. But I do agree that they probably should have brought probably a bigger map to Infinite Warfare as a DLC. I feel like they're bringing Rust back because they want to bring back hype. That's essentially what they did with the DLC 1 for Infinite Warfare. Obviously, the numbers for Infinite Warfare, everybody already knows it, are not the same as what Call of Duty is used to pulling. So essentially what they're trying to do is grab from their legendary Call of Duties, the Call of Duties that they've made in the past that everybody loves, and just kind of add a little bit of that into their current Call of Duty, probably to, you know, bring up the sales, you know, more money for Infinite Warfare, more money for Infinity Ward, more money for Activision, etc., etc. But I do agree with the fact that maybe they should have brought something different. They could have brought fucking Quarry would have been a great fucking map, right? No. Okay. Another thing some of you guys were telling me over on Twitter was there seems to be a lot of Modern Warfare 2 maps being brought back, the first DLC, and now this second DLC. Is there going to be a Modern Warfare 2 remastered? That doesn't really mean that there's going to be a Modern Warfare 2 remastered. If there's going to be a Modern Warfare 2 remastered, well, hallelujah. But if there is, I don't think they're going to release it during the time that they release World War 2. I think Activision is going to just straight up promote World War 2. They've put a lot of money into the Call of Duty. They have to. If Modern Warfare 2 Remastered comes, it's probably going to be before World War 2, maybe a month or two before, or maybe half a year after the release of World War 2. I don't know. That's if it comes out. But I don't think that they're going to be bringing Modern Warfare 2 Remastered how they did with MWR and Infinite Warfare, because it split up the community a lot. I mean, currently there's literally about 50% of the community in Infinite Warfare and another 50 or 75% in MWR. And this fucking scumbag! Yeah, I don't know if that's what Activision wants to do, you know? So I would see them do something else. So here's my question. question to you guys. What do you think about all of this? Because I didn't ask you guys on Twitter. I simply just posted about it. I bring you guys the news and what's up. And a lot of you guys just gave me your opinion. And I got... the Shikami Hollow Painkiller today, bro. Because I be rocking that painkiller 24/7, bro. One of the ways that I did mention over on my Twitter that's probably not possible because, I mean, I don't know. I haven't seen the map yet. At the time of me recording this video, the map trailer hasn't even been released. I'm hoping that what they did was make the map a little bit bigger. We talk about Call of Duty Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2. They had Nuketown, okay? Nuketown and Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 was essentially the same size because it was the same type of movement. When it came to Black Ops 3, they made Nuketown a little bit bigger. The center part of the map was obviously wider and a little bit longer. That's what she said. It seemed to work out perfectly fine. Obviously, Rust is smaller than Nuketown, but I would have... Look, speaking of the devil.
Vote the fucking map right now.
This guy just said, vote the fucking map right now.
Nope.
I feel like if they actually made the map bigger, it could probably work with the advanced movement. I saw Ryan over on Twitter. He actually tweeted something pretty cool. He said, what if the map is 24/7 EMP and you can't use advanced movements? That's actually pretty brilliant. Obviously, I don't think that's actually going to happen. By the way, I forgot to do the intro for this video. So here goes. What's up, guys? My name is Hollow. Welcome back! Kind of feels weird doing the intro, kind of like towards the end of the video, actually. This is actually a free-for-all, but it's only essentially... 7 players. If you were to play TDM or Domination, it's even crazier. Now imagine it with advanced movements. Yeah, it could get pretty nuts. So this guy, all he's gonna do is hide over there. Fuck me! And essentially, that's what happens. You spawn in. Look at that. Yeah, bro, I know that. No need to remind me, alright? By the way, for those of you guys who are wondering about World War II, reveal. I've been hearing it's probably going to be the third week of this month or the last week of this month. Like the last, I think it's the 25th. I'm not sure if it's the third or fourth week. If not, the first week of May, the reveal, which, to be honest, it's not bad. The reason why they're probably going to do this, probably because they don't obviously want to like launch the reveal trailer right when the DLC comes out or probably a day or two before the DLC comes out for Infinite Warfare. Because again, it's somewhat kind of like a conflict of interest. You know, it's not going to benefit them. What they really need to do, well, actually, never mind. They already have the intervention in Infinite Warfare. Oh my god. This guy has fucking noob tubes. This is obviously an SMG map or a Desert Eagle map. Sometimes even an intervention map. Unless he's got fucking painkiller. Look at this guy in the spaz, bro, going in. This is essentially why people don't want boost jumps in this map. Imagine this shit with... with double jumps and shit. I really don't know how there's gonna be wall running. Probably towards the back, something has been modified or whatnot. And probably these walls right here, instead of like being like fences, it's probably gonna be like walls and shit. Oh, and by the way, for those of you guys who missed it, the brand new zombies for Infinite Warfare actually looks pretty dope. They did the 80s and the 90s. Now they went back to the 70s. It's based off the streets of New York back in the 1970s, which is actually pretty cool. There's a lot of fucking kung fu shit going on there, which it's pretty dope. By the way, tomorrow I have something new for gaming that hasn't been revealed yet. It's kind of like top secret, and we're probably going to be one of the first to show it off on this channel. Hopefully, it comes in the mail tomorrow. It should be here tomorrow. It gets released tomorrow. You guys should definitely tune in back tomorrow. And then I'm also working on another crazy-ass edited video for you guys. And I was to post today, but obviously I had to bring this to you guys just so I can share my thoughts and opinions about Rust with you guys or whatnot and see what you guys have to say about it. So let me know, what do you guys think? And yeah, bye.